So today is the 19th, but now we're entering the 20th Mar Cheshvan. It's the birthday of the Rebbe Rashab, Rabbi Shalom Dov Ber, the fifth Lubavitcher Rebbe, known as the one who established the famous yeshiva, the Yeshiva Tomchei Temimim. Till today, the yeshiva, all the yeshivot of Chabad are receiving this name, Yeshiva Tomchei Temimim. And we know that was very picky about the student, the Talmidim, that were going to this yeshiva. And in general, he taught tremendous amount of Hasidut, very deep Hasidut. There is a book called the Taf Reish Samech Vav that was a group of discourses that was given, and it's called Hemshech because it was like one discourse that was said over 300-400 pages.
It went on.
Not here, I have it at home, but it's a very, very deep concept in Hasidut. And also Taf Reish Ayin Bet, another set of Maamarim, of Hasidic discourses, was said by Rabbi Shalom Ber. Great tzaddikim, so may zchut, the merit of the Rebbe, Rabbi Shalom Ber, would be, as we learned in Tanya recently in the last couple of days, that the passing of a tzaddik, once he goes to the higher world, he has the capability of helping us and bestowing blessings upon us, and especially those who are connected with his teaching. So I thought it's apropos to say a few things from his teaching on his birthday. We'll learn something from his teaching. Usually they put it in the back of the Dvar Malchut, right there, bring from each Rebbe, they bring a little bit. So, actually, in this this was taken from Taf Reish Ayin Bet, one of the continuation of these long discourses. You're not gonna find it there. It's only in this in Dvar Malchut, but it speaks about when God is commanded Noah to build the ark. He says to him, "Tzohar ta'asela teva ve'elama techalena milamala." So there's different interpretation. What does it mean, Tzohar ta'asela teva? Some say that he told him to create a window so we have light. Some say that he told him to put a gemstone, a special stone that would illumine the ark. But the commandment of God to Noah in building the ark was that this Tzohar, this window, will be Meshupat milamala berochav ama bilvad, that the opening should be a width of 18 inches to 26 inches, ama, from here to here. Rashi interpreted the word tzohar, yesh omrim chalon, v'yesh omrim even tova meira lahem. Some said that it's a window, some interpreted the words of Torah that it's a window, and some interpreted it as even tova, as a precious stone.
But why do you need precious stone?
You needed light in the ark. It was dark because it was almost like a submarine. This ark, because
it was
a tar. Gopher tasela teva. It was a gopher, meaning that it was made out of tar, right. So it was completely
over
sealed. Yeah, it was completely sealed, dark. So it made an opening, Mark made the tzor. So there's two opinions. I just said the one opinion is that it was even tova, it was a precious stone, and another opinion was literally a window.
So out of the whole ark was only that small window, 18 by 26.
Not the width of it was either 18 inches, right, or 26.
Whatever.
Yeah, not much light, but the Gemara in Sanhedrin explains it or speaks about it. Page Kufchet, Gemara in Sanhedrin said, Amar Rabbi Yochanan, Amar le'akadosh baruch hu le'noach. God said to Noach, Keva ba avanim tovot u'margaliot, shiyu ma'irim lachem katzoraim. He says, God said to Noach, you should place precious stones, that they, and gemstones, they should illumine and shine like the light of the afternoon. That's the language of the Gemara.
Was there any real light or beam of light in the stone, and then refracting the light?
Usually stones. I have a friend that is a diamond dealer, and he told me that he had one time that he had the diamond fell on the floor. So all he had to do is to close the light, and once he closed the light, he sees he takes the flashlight, and they right away reflect the light back.
See the reflections.
So yeah. So they
light, right. Reflects the light.
Right.
Reflects the stone. So,
right. So there.
So it must have been some kind of beam of light. Reflecting the light.
It might be also a special stone that actually generated light. We don't know. But Rashi, according to one of the interpretation, it was a gemstone that generated light. If it was directly or was a reflection of light, it doesn't say. But anyway, so the
stone like phosphorus that would reflect a lot of light.
Right.
But it's a dangerous stone.
Right. So it says the Gemara actually takes it further. The Gemara in Sanhedrin says that Hashem told Noach to put a few gemstones in the ark. And ultimately, they will radiate like the light of the afternoon. The Rebbe explains, "Mefaresh tzohar lashon tzohraim." He says the word tzohar is the same word as tzohraim, as the afternoon, because the afternoon is a time that there's a lot of light. "V'tzirich leavin ma'u inyan she'atevat yeh meirak tzohraim." So he says, question number one, the Rebbe Rashab is asking, why the teva, why the ark has to shine like the afternoon? Why does it have to have light like, maybe you could have a little bit dim light. Why does it have to be like the afternoon? Validei ma, tiye meira, and through what it's going to shine? Not through the window. It says specifically through these precious stones. So why not? Why not through the window? Why do we have to have the precious stones? Gam tzich lavin. That was one question. And then it says, "Gam tzich lavin sheichut inyan ve'lamatech alena." And why the Torah tells Noach, Hashem tells Noach, ve'lamatech alena, that he explains exactly how it has to be completed, the amount of light, the amount of opening. Lema shekatuv tzor tase derichorav lelemeimor. Seemingly, it should have been written. Ze, the commandment ve'elamatech alena. Quote them, if you want to tell me about an opening, tell me about an opening before. What's the connection between tzor, ta'aseh la'teva, and then you tell me about the opening should be this measurement of 26 inches. Gabei medidat ha'teva shomer ve'shloshim amah komata. Aval elamim ha'osham ve'elamah. When the Torah described the height of the ark, the Torah should have said, you're making it 30 amot komata, make it 30 amot high. And then that the opening should be ama, should be one hand breadth, which is between 18 to 26 inches. Uchshev sig ma shekatuv tzohar ta'aseh ve'achar kach omer ve'elamah mashma. We obviously have to say that this concept of tzohar, the light that comes to the ark, ve'ama, and this opening, they have to be connected to each other. We just need to understand what the connection. It makes sense to say logically that there is a connection, but we need to understand what is the connection.
It's not like the connection, like the light of the windows coming through the temple mount. The temple was outside, so they could see the light coming out. In this case, Hashem wanted to radiate the light into the ark.
Correct.
Maybe in that direction.
Well, Avin called this, so in order to understand all of the above, Yesh Lakdim Ashenit Bayer, the Shem Sefirahu, in the previous Maamar, I guess the previous discourse, it speaks about the Shem Sefirahu, Lashon Mispar, when it's by the Inyan Mispar, Ubechilim de Esther Sefirot. So, we right away goes into the Kabbalistic explanations. What is the word Sefirah? So it says Sfira is the same. It's the same meaning as the word mispar, as the word number. Ve'nitba'er, the inyan mispar u'bechirim de'esar sefirot. It says the whole concept of numbers, of counting and numbers, is connected with limitations. And if it's connected with limitation, therefore it's associated with the 10 vessels of 10 vessels, or the 10 sefirot, the 10 manifestations. Ve'ikar mispar shu hagbalat davar. And in generally, you would see the concept of number, which is limiting. This is the amount. This is the bill. Whenever you have a number, it's the concept of limitation. So you see, we explain that the numbers are primarily in Malchut, in the Sfira, in the manifestation of kingship. Shesham ikar kelim, vessels are primarily in Malchus. כפי שנתבהר ההפרש בין הכלים של ספירת המלכות שעניינם להגביל, הכלים של הספירות שמעלה שעניינם לגלות האור. So in general, we know that the kelim, the vessels that are within kingship, their primary objective is to limit the light, contract the light, and the vessels that are higher than malchut, their primary objective is to give light. One is to give and one is to contract. Malchus is always contracting. Like a converter that takes 220 and transforms it to 110. Yeah. Shayach mispar gam b'madrigot lemala me'amalchut. It says the concept of number is can be said also about levels that are higher than malchut. V'u bechinat mispar ha'orot, ha'mispar zeh u bechinat lo yisafer. So we know that it's one of the brachot of God to Abraham, it says, "Lo yisafer merov." Also, the blessing of God to Yaakov, "Va'ata amarta itev iti v'mcha, v'samti et zaracha k'kochvei ha'shamayim, v'chachol asher asfat hayam, asher lo yisafer merov." That will never be counted. God is blessing Yaakov that his descendants will multiply so much that they can be no longer be under a number. They will not be counted. So he says, when it comes to light that are higher than Malchut, it says there is a number, but it's not, it cannot be counted. It's like someone's going to say, go count the sand of the sea, how much sand there is in the sea, or in the seashore, how much sand. There is a number, but we don't know the number. Lo yisafer. Right. It says, "Ainu sheyesh b'ze sheyachut legvul umidah shelachen nikra mispar." So there is some relations to limitation, but it's in such a way asher lo yisafer shein b'ze kol itchakut veitgalut. There's no division. There's no revelation. Kvishin b'er inyan ze v'kama ofanim b'sof ha'mamar kodem u'mispar ha'kelim u'v'chinat mispar u'gvul mamash. So when it comes to the number of vessels, they have a number and it's limited. How is it all connected to the teva and the sfira? We know that the Baal Shem Tov explained that when it comes to Sfirat HaOmer, also again the word Sfira, so it says Sfira is Melshon Sapir, the sapphire stone, Evan Sapir. So speaking about Evan, a stone that shines, it gives light. So there's a stone called Sapir, sapphire in Hebrew, Sapir. And Sapir is the same word as a Sfira. So it's all connected. But over here, they only bring a small portion of it. So this is a concept about...
Is the same stone that Hashem used to write the first tablet? Did he use sapphire? Or did he use a different stone?